back to the altar and say, God, I need you more than the very air that's in my lungs. I cannot make it without you. I need you.
I'd rather be part of the solution than part of the problem. Can somebody say amen? I know church is a lot more fun when we feel like things are falling into place.
Of our heart, he comes in and he says, I want to be Lord of your life, and I want to change your life, and I want to redeem your life, and I want to forgive your sin. You don't deserve my mercy. I want to give it to you. Believe me when I say this. When God makes you a promise, he intends to keep that promise. He will never, ever. It is the power of that same Spirit that shook the world when Christ died on that cross. The Bible says that the earth literally cracked and shook because the Spirit of God that was contained in the man Jesus was released and was poured out. Why? So that you and I can be
power. Design marijuana to make you happy.
That's right.
And I don't know who needs to hear that today, but maybe you need to hear that.
Yeah.
And let's just be honest. If you think marijuana makes you happy, you ain't never tried the Holy Ghost. Because you know what? That joint burns out. Well, where? How did I get on this? That bottle runs empty. That pill bottle goes empty. And you got to keep reaching for more. My Bible tells me that when you drink from this well, you never thirst again. That's what the redemptive power of God is. Now when we look at this principle that he said that the fruit of the womb of the woman is going to crush the heel of the serpent. Right?
Come on.
That didn't happen immediately. There was thousands of years before this ever happened.
Right.
But let me tell you, God had a plan from the beginning that he was going to crush the head of Satan. He was going to cause a redemption to come to humanity that the devil could not stop.
Right. Right.
Amen.
That's right.
The devil couldn't deal with.
Come on. Come on, man. Be born again of water and of spirit. He cannot enter the kingdom of God. I still believe in holiness living. I still believe you've got to have a pastor in your life. And more than anything, I still believe that there is only one God, and his name is Jesus.
And everything about you will change. You have to touch him. You have to get his attention. I can prove it.
Never forget what you walked away from. Never forget that you walked into the kingdom of God with addictions in your mind. Never forget that you walked into the kingdom of God carrying the baggages and the weights of sin that were so heavy that you couldn't even pick your head up. But somehow the Spirit of the Lord swept in that place and you couldn't understand it. You didn't even know what it was like. But all of a sudden, you know your hands were lift and surrender, and there wasn't weights on them. But the power of the mercy of God set you free.
Do you know Jesus? Do you know him that way? Do you know he's your healer? Can I tell you sometimes, Pastor? You know what we do? Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying you can't go to the doctor. You need to listen to the doctor.
Yeah.
But at the same time, sometimes we just need to say, Jesus.
like you've got victory. You want to praise him like you've broken through. You want to stop looking cute. You want to stop looking fancy.
Jesus tonight, somebody give him a shout of praise. Come on, hey, 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 hey.
Blessed assurance of Jesus is mine. Oh, what a fool. Glory divine, heir of salvation, purchased of God, born of His Spirit. Oh, I'm washed in His blood.
Yeah.
The name of the Lord is a strong tower. In the name.
I'm running in. When my family is gone, I'm running in. When I have no money in the bank, into the strong tower.
Can stop.